profound is one of the most studied phenomenon in all psychology. Youth aggression is a complex phenomenon with multiple risk factors, including media violence, among many others. Why is media violence so bad for children to watch? You might ask yourself why it's important, but really you should be thinking about how dangerous kids can become from watching violence on TV. Even in the future, when you have children, you will not want your child growing up watching something so horrific. Do you think TV violence is okay for young children to watch? I'm here to help you understand the effects and influences that TV violence can have on young children. Today I will talk about what TV violence really is, the effects TV violence has on children, the danger of different behaviors that kids can change into from watching too much violence. So before we talk about how dangerous it can be for kids to watch violence, we should first talk about what TV violence really is and how it can affect children. So media violence is visual portrayals of acts of physical aggression by one human or human-like character against another. A quote from a scientist states, by the time the average U.S. child starts elementary school, he or she will have seen 8,000 murders and 100,000 acts of violence on TV. From an article, TV and Film Violence, it states researchers followed 329 subjects over 15 years. They found out that children who have been exposed to violent TV shows are more likely to later be convicted of a crime. So from children watching too much violent TV shows, they can promote violent and aggressive behavior in the children later on in life. So on average, a child watches TV 2 to 3 hours daily during the weekdays and 3 to 4 hours on the weekends. That adds up to about 1,200 hours of TV in a year. During those hours, those children have seen some sort of violence on TV. So now that we understand what TV violence really is and how it can affect young children, we can now discuss the dangers it can cause kids to go through. According to Robert Sage, he states that children learn from what they see. For example, a man was in the hospital and got shot and said it hurt really bad, but it never seemed to hurt on television. So children's first strategy they will go to is to use violence rather than the lash. Children are led to passively accept violence as a fact of life, making them less likely to intervene when violence occurs. The dangers of letting children watch violent shows can really impact their life in the future. So after talking about the danger of TV violence and having children, we can talk about the different behaviors children can have from watching too much violence. Mental health professionals are often asked to give advice about managing children's aggression. Children exposed to media violence and aggression have raised public health concerns. Children sometimes have to attend therapy because their behavior is so bad. These behaviors that children can end up having after watching too much violence from TV shows and other media can really harm and impact their life and others. So as you have learned, TV violence can cause some damage to young children. Would you want to see a child go through that? Any young child that watches all of that violence will not think straight in the future and will always want to argue. Mentioned earlier about the dangers it can cause children to do or say can really scare others, even when with their different behaviors on top of that, because their moods can just switch. So would you want a child to frighten you from what they say or do? So if you're ever babysitting or watching over kids for a little bit and something with violence pops up on TV, change the channel so you don't have to watch it, because now you know what can happen with children if they watch too much of violence on TV.